Let's talk about the prepositions on and in. A preposition is something that goes before the noun. A noun is a person, place, or thing. So whatever you're, it's a thing, you're talking about something. Now, the location of something around or on top or inside the noun. It usually goes before the noun in the sentence, and that's why it's called a preposition. It's pre as in before the position. So preposition, preposition. Okay, so the prepositions on and in. On, of course, is here's a rock. I'm on the rock. If I'm in, I'm inside the rock. There's various nouns: in front, behind, beside, right, left, inside, around, above, below, etc. But the prepositions in and on mean in the rock or on the rock. Now, when you're speaking various ways in English, we have different phrases such as arriving on time or arriving in time. Now, they may sound the same to you, and if you mix them up, it's not going to confuse the native English speaker too much, but they do mean slightly different things. If you're arriving on time, you're arriving on a specific time, so it could be exactly on a certain time or within a certain amount of time that is specific, like 5 minutes before 1 or exactly at 1 o'clock if something starts at 1 o'clock. So you have arrived on time. On is specific. Now, in time, arriving in time would be you don't have a specific time in mind. You're just arriving within a certain amount of time in order to have seen an event or participated in an event. So let's say there's a class, someone walked in the classroom and fell down. Well, did you arrive in time to see that person fall down? You know? So what if they were late to class? Oh, you were late to class? Did you arrive in time to see someone so fall down? It was really funny. So he arriving in time, like I arrived just in time to see that car crash over on 31st Avenue. Or I arrived at the red light just in time to stop my brakes before the cop saw me. Something like that. So on a specific in is within a certain amount of time. On is actually you've already taken amount of time and then you're going to put it on your whatever is going on that time. So on is like specific for days, like on Monday, on Tuesday, and specific dates, on the 31st of May or on the 13th of July. It's not in the 13th of July. Now, when we talk about months, we say in the month. So it will happen in July. It will happen in January. It will happen, and now years, same thing, 2015. It will happen in 2015. It will happen in 2017. Or it already happened in 2012. We don't say on 2012, okay? On is a specific day or time. Now, when we talk about on time or in time, okay, we already, it's kind of the same thing. So now, how about thinking about something? It's been on my mind for a while. Or that's in my mind. I've had that in mind. Now, they pretty much mean the same thing, but they're slightly different. If you're saying it's on my mind, that's something that's come upon you, something that has concerned you and worried you or made you think deeply about something. It is something that an outside thing that went and came upon your mind. It came upon you. It's on my mind. Yes, those kids in the Philippines in Manila, those poor kids that are street kids, they've been on my mind. First time I saw them, I just kept worrying and thinking, and I'd like to go help them out. Okay? Now, in my mind is something that's in you, something you've already established within you. It's something expressing out of you. It's come, you know, Yes, I do think people need help, and it's been in my mind for a while to believe I should go help someone. So it's in my mind, okay? Now, I've been thinking about you. Oh, I love you so much. You've been on my mind ever since the first day we met. So someone who affected you, they've been on your mind, okay? Now, it's in my mind, like a belief. It's in my mind to believe love is important, or it's been in my mind to believe that in God, something like that. It's in my mind. It's been in my mind. God has been in my mind ever since whenever, okay? It's hard to understand the difference unless you're a native speaker, but you can practice and you'll understand the difference. Okay, now on the wall, you're hanging a picture on the wall. Obviously, there's a picture right there. It's on the wall, on the surface of the wall. It's not inside the wall, okay? But the nail that I used to hang the picture is in the wall. It's stuck in the wall, inside the wall. It's not on the wall, but the picture is touching the surface. It's on the wall. So think about that. It's like on the table, not in the table. Okay, now for like a classroom, you'd say I'm in my class, not on my class, because you're participating within an activity with people, that you're in the class, not on class, okay? So you're in a chair, okay? That guy is sitting in the chair. We say in the chair all the time. Usually it's because the chair has, you know, armrests, and it's kind of surrounding you. So you're kind of in it, okay? You're not really on it necessarily. You are literally on it, but we say in it. Now, we also, what's funny is we also say he's on the chair. Well, which chair is he at? He's on the blue chair. Or usually we'll say he's in the blue chair, but he's sitting on the chair. Well, where is he sitting? He's sitting on a surface. He's sitting on something. Is he sitting on the bed? Is he sitting on the floor? Or is he sitting on a chair? Oh, he's sitting on a chair. Oh, really? Which chair is he in? Well, he is in the blue chair. You see how that changes from on to in? Do you understand that? If you need more help, ask questions in the comments and I'll try to help you out more. Okay, what else? You're in a car. You're not on a car. But you can be on a bus. Oh, he's on a bus. He has jumped on the bus, or he has rode on the bus to get to school. But also, he's in the bus. It kind of comes from, like, let's say a jeepney. Okay. You kind of step on a platform to get on it. You're on it. It kind of comes from that, like the, you know, being on a carriage, you know, from the old days. You're sitting on a carriage and the horses are pulling you, or you're sitting on a bus. He got up on a truck, lifted himself up to get into a big truck. Okay, but then, oh, he rode a truck. Where is he at now? Oh, he's in the truck still. So then we say he's in the truck. We don't necessarily say, oh, he's on the truck. Now, let's say the truck's parked or the bus is parked, and he's still sitting there waiting for the bus to drive off. Oh, he's in the bus over there. He's in that bus. Oh, really? But then we can also say he's on that bus. I think on a bus or on a truck usually means the truck's in motion. So you can interchange that a lot, but it has basically the same meaning. So I believe Filipinos, when they say they're getting out of a vehicle, they say, go down, I'm going down. Like, all they're doing is getting out of their car. We say in America, we say getting out of the car. Get out of the car. Hey, get out of the car. We don't say, go down from the car. Or go down, it's time to go down. No, we say, get out, getting out of the car. So it's interesting. So if you need any more help, ask more questions and I'll try to make more videos or use comments to help you out. And I hope this helped you out, and have a great day.